Welcome to the One Minute Apologist. We interview the world's leading apologists to provide credible answers to curious questions.
There's so much when it comes to the afterlife, and especially as it relates to, you know, what is kind of the destiny of those who do not believe in Christ. Some have, like Origen, have ended up as universalists. You have other people who would be annihilationists. Then you have even the traditionalists who would say, okay, hell's a place of, you know, eternal conscious torment. But then the nature of such a place, is it literal? And some would say, yeah, yes, no. What do you think when it comes to like the worm doesn't die, or darkness, or the eternal lake of fire? Are you gonna literally be just, you know, burning, incinerated for eternity?
Well, remember, hell is created for Satan and his demons. Now, they are immaterial beings, so fire wouldn't affect them. And it would seem to me that those are metaphors to communicate destruction. And they would be metaphors that have opposite connotations. If you have outer darkness on one hand and fire on the other, they would seem to be in conflict. So I don't think they're literal, but that doesn't mean to communicate that they're not serious, or this is not a place that you don't want to go. It is a place you don't want to go, but I think that they are metaphors. As we said earlier, hell is literally separation from God. That's what it means. And it's described as a place of destruction. Fire is destructive. Being in a bottomless pit would be destructive. Being in a perpetually burning dump would be destructive. So it's meant to communicate destruction rather than to say that there is literal fire or literal darkness.
So in James 3, where we learn, oh, the tongues of fire, that wouldn't be wise to take that literally and say your tongues of fire.
Right.
Rather, our tongue can be destructive.
You're pretty good at this.
Hey.